Welcome back to ECOSTRESS tutorials. This tutorial will teach you how to download ECOSTRESS data from AppEEARS.
Let's start by searching the web for AppEEARS. It's spelled APPEEARS. Click on this first link. Now click Sign In. This will take you to the login page, where you can enter your credentials and press Log In. Once you are logged in, find where it says Extract at the top and select Area. We have three options. You can either start a new request, copy a previous request, or upload a request file. Today we're going to start a new request. Click here. This will take us to a window where we can extract our area sample. Let's start by naming our sample. I'm interested in salt and sea data from June of 2024. Next, we can define our area of interest. There's a couple ways you can do this. One way is by uploading a shapefile. If you followed our QGIS creating a shapefile tutorial, you should have a folder saved with your shapefile documents. In this folder, you have all the documents you need. Right-click on the folder and press Compress. This will create a zipped version of your shapefiles. Drag and drop this into the blue box. You will now see your shapefile visualized on the map. Alternatively, if you're interested in a larger area of interest, you can also draw a polygon directly on the map. You can either select this icon to draw specific points, or you can select this one to draw a rectangle. I'm going to select this one because I'm interested in the area around the sea as well. Now you can see that my area of interest is defined by what's in this highlighted blue rectangle. Next, we need to set a temporal range. We can do this by setting the start and end date. For the start date, click on the calendar icon. First, let's select the year. This will give us some options. I'm going to select 2024. And then we select the month. I'm interested in June. Finally, select the day. I'm going to put June 1st. For the end date, do the same process. Select the calendar icon, year, month, and day. Now we have to select the layers that we want to include in our sample. Go ahead and enter ECOSTRESS into the search for a product. I'm going to click on this first option for land surface temperature and emissivity. I'm going to scroll all the way down to the layer that I'm interested in, which is this SDSLST. The land surface temperature. I'm going to click this plus, which will add it to the selected layers. Now I'm going to click this X and search for a new product. This product that I'm interested in is also an ECOSTRESS product, so I'm going to search ECOSTRESS again. This time I'm going to select this one for the cloud mask. This one only has one layer option. I'm going to click the plus to add this to the selected layers. Finally, we select our layer format. For ECOSTRESS, we use GeoTIFF. And then we have to select our projection. You can search for a specific projection if you have something in mind, or you can click in this box and select from one of the dropdowns. I'm going to select Geographic. Once all your settings are correct, press this Submit button. You will get this notification that the area sample request was successfully submitted. Now, let's navigate to the Explore tab. Here, you will see our request. Right now, it says Pending. If it says Queued, that means that it's waiting to be picked up. Once it says pending, that means it has been picked up. Eventually, it will start processing. We can let this load for a while. You will eventually see this progress bar appear. This will tell you how much of your request has been completed. If you want, you can keep this window open, or you can close it. You will receive an email when your request is done. Once your request has finished loading, log back into Earth Data and go to the Explore tab. Find your request. Make sure that under Status, it says Done. If it doesn't, that means it's still loading. Click this Download button. At the top, you will see the supporting files. This includes a README, QC information, and metadata. If you want to download any of these files, click on their name to begin the download. Below the supporting files section, you will see all the files that you requested listed, along with their size. Next to the file names are checkboxes. If you wish to download only a few of the files requested, you can select the checkboxes only next to the file names you wish to download. This is helpful if you want to download just a sample to run a test on. Alternatively, if you want to download all the files that you requested, select the empty box next to name to check all the boxes on. Once you have selected your desired files, click the Download dropdown and select Download Files. This will make the download process begin. A progress bar will appear, showing you how many files you have downloaded and the total number of files, as well as the percent of the download that is complete. This may take a few minutes, but the time depends on how many files you are requesting to download. Once the download is complete, you can find the files by navigating to your Downloads folder. Here you will see all the downloaded files. For best practice, put all of these files into a folder. One last tip. If you want to know more information about one of the files you downloaded, copy the file name. And paste it into a search bar. Select a link under LPDAC. Here, you can get more information about the product, including a description, user guide, and citation help.
Thank you for watching this ECOSTRESS tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. For more trainings, tutorials, and information, including a written version of this tutorial, go to ecostress.jpl.nasa.gov/documents, which will be linked in the description.